Hi everyone. Hi. So I can't believe this is finally happening. I've heard so much about Facebook Live, and I'm so glad that I finally got the opportunity to do this. So thank you for that. And most importantly, my lovely fans, all of you here, and everyone who's watching, thank you so much. And let's start. I'm ready to start this fun interaction.
What was your best moment from the shoot of Triple X?
I think there's, well, let me break it down. I think my best experience, the question is, what was my best experience of shooting on the set of Triple X? And I would break that down into two separate parts. One was the professional part, obviously, of working in a completely new environment. I felt like a complete newcomer. I was extremely nervous in the beginning to work with an entirely new team in a completely new environment, a new setup. But I think the one thing to also appreciate from there is how, in terms of technology, how advanced they are. So that's something I got to learn. But other than that, you know, I felt like there were so many similarities between how we work in India and how they work over there. And for me, and I've said this before, I feel like that's a huge reflection of how much Indian cinema has progressed over the last couple of years. And at a personal level, I was living alone there for 4 months. So I enjoyed every bit of doing all the domestic work, whether it was cooking for myself every night or doing my laundry or cleaning my apartment. I just enjoyed doing all of that.
If you were a Facebook emotion, which one would you be?
We have a few here if you want. Yes.
Sure.
Which one do you want?
With the tongue. I love that. Anything around the smiley, I think the smiley is... my most favorite.
Hi, Debika.
Hi.
What would you do if you woke up as lonely as you?
I would sit in a plane and get myself to India right now.
If your Triple X co-stars would come to India, which is one place you would surely take them?
You know, they've asked me this question while I was there. Most of them, all of them actually, none of them have been to India, and they always ask me about India. But I think that's the fascinating part, that you can't summarize India in one word or one sentence. How do I explain to them that the north of India is so different from the south of India? Culturally, we're all the same. You know, whether it's the north, whether it's the south, east, west, culturally there's... But there's also so many differences in the food, in the way we celebrate certain festivals. So there's a lot of similarities, but so many differences as well. So what I suggested to them was if they could, you know, take 2 or 3 weeks to actually do, you know, travel the whole of India. There's also so many different ways of exploring India. You know, there's so much to experience that I think. And the one thing I always said is that India's an addiction, you know. You can never get enough of it. I know so many people who've come here, non-Indians, who've come here, apprehensive initially, and then they leave. And then they're like, they're missing something, and they don't know what their feeling is. But there's something about India that keeps drawing you back. It happens with me when I was filming and I came back. But it happens, I've spoken to a lot of people who just travel a lot, never been to India before, and then they come to India and they're like, it's something that keeps drawing you back again and again. Is it the people? Is it the, you know, it's something, there is an energy. And I hope they experience that as well whenever they come. I'm sure they'll be the same.
Which was the last movie you saw?
Any movie. Which was the last movie I saw?
I watched two movies on a flight recently, I know this. One was a movie called Maggie's Plan, and I watched one more. I watched Deadpool, and I watched, one more movie, it'll come back to me. Ah, Mother's Day. Yeah. Hi, Deepika. Hi. My question to you is, if a genie could offer you three wishes, what would they be?
If a genie could offer me three wishes, what would that mean? I don't know, maybe more time with my family to somehow bring us back together in the same city so that we can all live together. What else? I don't know, maybe help me guys go on. I wish I could not work out and feel great all the time.
More time with
fans. Okay. You need to interact with us more often.
Yes. Yes.
I promise you.
You do cooking classes with Asia.
Yes.
Have you cooked anything that you learned?
Yes, we were so excited that as soon as we came back, the next weekend I went back to Bangalore and we were like showing off to our parents and like making everything from scratch, and it was a great experience. But you know, more than the cooking part of it, I think it gave me an amazing, I just discovered my sister in a completely different way. I think just the two of us, we've never done a sister holiday. We've always done a family holiday, or then I've gone with my friends. But this was the first time that my sister and I went alone on a holiday without my parents. And 1 week together, we travel together, we cook together. It teaches you so much about yourself, it teaches you so much about the other person. And I think it gave me an amazing opportunity to just get to know her better. I moved away from home at a very young age, and she was still growing up. And I think I missed those few years when she was, when she was growing. And when I see her now, she's so beautiful and she's such a lovely person that I feel like I'm rediscovering her again.
Hey, Deepika. We all know that you are the fittest actress in the industry.
Don't lie.
You post your Twitter videos of your fitness.
I don't know if I'm the fittest. I know I'm fit, but there are also a lot of other fit people. But anyway, ask me your question.
But what do you do when you are fit?
When I'm free?
Yeah, when you take a break.
I sleep. I love sleeping. I love catching up on sleep. I love doing things around the house. I'm extremely... I find that very therapeutic. Whenever I have some time off to just be around the house, do things around the house, I find that very, very therapeutic. But you know, for me, fitness and exercise, I don't do it as a burden. For me, it's not like I'm forced to do it. I do it because I enjoy it. I do it because I feel good. I enjoy cooking. I love listening to music. And yeah, like I said earlier, I think any given opportunity, I try and spend as much time with my parents and my sister as possible.
Hi, I'm Ayush. Can you please tell us that one role that you could do or you would do that you wish you could have done?
Well, I think I know the question you're asking me, but I would like to say that if I had the opportunity to do a film again, I would love to relive Piku again, because I think that was such a beautiful, not just movie, but also just the entire experience of working with Shujit sir, being on that film set, working with Amiji and Irfan, just that entire experience, it was so seamless, it was so much fun. And on top of that, you make a great great movie. You know, so I think that just that entire phase in my life, I wish that, you know, I could relive that moment, those moments in my life again.
Sir Deepa, my question for you is that if you could have one superpower, what would it be?
It's actually really bizarre. Well, I don't think it's bizarre, but a lot of people think it's bizarre. If I could be a vacuum cleaner and just suck out all the dirt, like it annoys me when I see like litter and when I see like, you know, like just done gently. It really bothers me. So I can, of course, obviously keep my surroundings clean, but sometimes I wish that I'm driving somewhere and I wish there was like one big machine that would just suck up everything in one go and everything's like pretty and clean and green. Is that weird?
Hello.
Hi. Again.
If you left alone on an island,
So
what three things you want with you?
I would definitely a boat / float so I could come back. Maybe some nice music, because I think music, I find that very therapeutic. And it's fun, music is nice. And maybe go with some friends. You have some company? Is that valid? Is that a valid answer? Okay, all of us will go. Everyone here, we'll all go. But you all have to swim across. I'll only be on the island. And then you'll have to swim and come to me. So I'll have set up everything nicely, organize everything before everyone arrives.
Just swimming as well.
That too, yeah.
Please tell us about your favorite book and a movie, your favorite.
My favorite book? I would say Fault in Our Stars, which was, I think it was a beautiful book and also a very well done movie. Both rolled into one.
What is your style icon?
My style icon might sound very cliche, maybe a lot of girls say that, but it's true. I think we all grew up somewhere with a huge influence from our mothers. You know, I think you see how they dress up, you know, you see how they conduct themselves. And I think whatever their style might be, somewhere or the other, it has a huge influence on us as little girls when we are growing up. So of course today when I think back and I can sound really intelligent and I can, you know, name like, you know, a lot of people, but I think if I go down to the basics and if I think of myself as a little young girl, it is my mother. You know, every given opportunity, if there was fancy dress in school, you want to go to your mother's cupboard and see what is that one outfit that you can steal. If there was an event in school and you were allowed to wear some makeup, then you're stealing your mother's makeup. Or my mother used to do my makeup for me sometimes, just put some like rouge on my cheeks and feel like, oh, I've worn a lot of makeup. So basically, I think my mother, she's always been very elegant and very understated. And I think that has kind of rubbed off on me over the years. Of course, as you grew up, you know, different influences in your life and you evolve as a person, but I think the basic is from my mom.
Hi, Deepika. I want to thank
your mother.
Yeah. I want to thank you for all the amazing roles you've played, and some of the other way they have been very relatable.
Thank you.
So my question is, from Naina's maturity to Tara's sense of freedom, to Piku's determination and Mastani's courage, they have all been inspiring. Which one is your most favorite? The one you relate to the most?
So there's Tara, there's Naina, Piku, and Mastani. I don't think that I can say I entirely relate to just one character. I think that with every role that you play, with every film, you put a little bit of yourself in every character that you play. And so whether it was Mastani's strength or Naina's vulnerability or Piku has that relatable quality, I think all of these, you know, all these things, or Tara, for example, what she goes through in relationships, I think all of that somewhere, for every character that you choose to play in a movie, there's something that you identify with. Or you take that character and you start, you know, you put a little bit of yourself into that. Like Naina Talwar, for example, I may not have been that first venture of the bright student, but I relate to that journey that she went through. You know, I was someone who not great in academics and I was not a topper in class, but I've been through her journey of self-discovery and coming into her own and becoming a more confident person. I've been through that journey. With Mastani, I relate to the maternal side of her. I relate to the strength that Mastani had. No matter what she went through, she was always a very, very strong woman. So there's little traits in every character that I've played that I completely identify with. They're all lovely. Thank you.
What was the one thing you missed the most while you were shooting?
Home food, you know, no matter how convenient it is today, and you know, Indian food is easily available. I think that's the just home, simple home food, I think is what I missed the most. Of course, I also missed familiar faces like my managers and my team, and I missed, you know, my parents. Although my parents came there and spent some time with me, but you miss the familiar surroundings and things that are familiar to you and make you feel comfortable. That's all I missed.
Hi. Is there any one Hollywood?
No, I think like I answered this question earlier, I think the way we work here today, I think we've evolved a lot. And there's absolutely no difference between working here and working there, honestly. It's exactly the same, the process is the same. The positive things, the negative things, it's all really, it's all the same. And I think the amazing part is that everyone is in this business today to make beautiful movies and tell interesting stories and make memorable characters. I think that's what everyone is working towards.
Hi. Yeah. You have millions of fans across the globe. What message would you give to them for their love and support through your journey?
I don't think what I say will do justice to what I feel. I know the value that my fans bring to my life every single day. And I'll tell you this, it's not the fact that you guys celebrate my success or the fact that you're with me when things are good, but the fact that you're standing by me when things are not good. I think for me that is really what fans are. You know, you all of you have been with me on that, on this amazing journey right from the beginning, and none of this would have been possible without, you know, your constant love and support and the fact that you all have stood by me no matter what. And that says a lot. You know, it allows me as a person and as an actor to go out there and be fearless and do the kind of movies that I do and be the person that I want to be, because I know I have all of you guys supporting me in everything that I do.
Hi.
Hi.
One place you've never been, but would we like to go?
One place I've never been that I would like to go. I'd like to explore the east of India. That's one side I've not explored much, so I would like to explore the east.
Hello. You have worked with many great people, with great stars. Which one actor or actress you want to work with in upcoming movies?
See, these kind of lovely questions get us into trouble very often. I think gone are the days when you wanted to just work with someone just because you wanted to be seen with, you know, X, Y, Z person or wanted to work with them. I think it's important that a person fits a particular role or is right for the film. But I can tell you from the people that I've already worked with, if there was someone that I would like to work with again, it would be Irfan. I think he really challenged me, and you know, as an actor, and it was one of my most enriching experiences.
What inspires you to do the most challenging roles for every film?
What inspires me to... I think the fact that I like challenging myself. I don't like anything that's easy. I think every time you read a script, you want that feeling, that butterfly feeling in your stomach, of feeling nervous and not knowing, you know, how you're going to do this. I think that's the challenge, to be able to find those kind of scripts, to be able to find that thing that's going to shake you up and, you know, get you thinking and wonder how you're going to do this, but at the same time, somewhere you know you're going to do it. You know, you have a fantastic team, and I'll have a fantastic director who will help me achieve that. But I think it's important to go through that process of not knowing, and that process of feeling those butterflies in your stomach. I think that's what keeps me going. Okay. Munira Hamid Hussain from Singapore says, I have a question. Who is your inspiration and why? Who is my inspiration and why? People. I think people inspire me. I think every day we meet different kinds of people, so many different personalities. So I think people inspire me. I get intrigued. I'm also a very quiet person by nature, so it gives me the opportunity to watch and observe people. And I get very intrigued. You know, sometimes I'm sitting at a cafe or I'm, you know, at the airport waiting to board a flight. And I love watching people. I love watching, and I make up my own stories in my head about where this person must be going, where he must be coming from. And I just make up my own stories in my head. So I think people inspire me. But closer home, I would say my parents inspire me a lot. I think I've learned a lot from anything else. I think the fact that I think I have wonderful role models at home, and for all of us, I think for all of us somewhere, even if we may not consciously realize it, I think somewhere our parents inspire us a lot. We consciously or subconsciously want to be like them, at least in my case. You know, for me, my parents are also an inspiration. Ankita Sarkar says, what is your best childhood memory? Well, I have a lot of fun childhood memories, but the two things that I can think of now are, one, when every morning we would go to school, my father would wear his lungi, and we had a carpool, so because there were a lot of us in our building who would go to the same school. So every
one parent had the duty to drop all of us to school. So I remember us, all of us in my Fiat car, my dad would drive us, and all of us would like kind of go to school. So that's like one memory. And then playing with my friends in the evening, in the building, like we all play cricket or we go cycling around the building, or just when you come back from school and you quickly want to drink your milk and you quickly want to run down because you know all your friends are down in the building and you don't want to miss out. For me, I think those are my most favorite childhood memories. At least that's what I can think of now. Lotika Champion Klang says, you said that after reading one scene of Piku, you decided to act in the film. What scene was that? The very first scene in the movie where, the opening scene where you see Piku's like, she's getting late for work, she's trying to handle the dhobi, she's trying to like give her baba her medicines. That entire scene and where her father's saying something to her and she's like, she just storms out of the house. Shujit sir just narrated that entire scene to me and I just looked at him and I said, when are we starting? Like, I want to do this movie now. So that was the scene. Nidul Nafiul from Dhaka, Bangladesh says, awards, commercial success, critics, who is the most important for you? My fans. I think all of it. I think, I think the audience is important. I think commercial success is important. I think critics are important. I think all of it is important. But I think that most importantly, you have to be happy with your own choices. The reasons for why you do a certain movie, being happy on that film set when you're working, enjoying that experience of being on that film set. I think all of these things are important for me, the success of a movie. And then of course you want your film to be critically, to get that kind of appreciation, but you also want it to do well at the box office. I think eventually the idea is to hopefully be part of movies that become iconic and where people remember you for the characters that you play. I think that is important. And the last question, Aditya Ak says, what are the things that you always carry along with you wherever you go out somewhere? Now, that's a very interesting question. So, I have a pouch. You know about my pouch? Okay. I have a pouch which has everything in it. Safety pins, band-aids, medicine, rubber bands, sui dhaga, buttons, hooks, what else, nail file, biscuits, mint, perfume, everything, name it. I literally travel in that one bag, everything's in it. So whatever you need, I'm the go-to person. Great.
So we have a few questions from the employees as well.
Okay.
Hi.
Hi.
First off, thanks for all the great work you do with the Live Love Laugh Foundation.
Thank you.
You've been working with Ashu and Anisha
yes.
for a while, so thank you for that.
Thank you.
I have two questions. One is, how do you deal with criticism? You're just too impressive to deal with criticism. And I believe all of us have a lot to learn from you, so how do you deal with criticism? That's my first question. I'll come to the second one in a minute. One of my team members specifically asking you, have you ever been bullied as a child? And what's your take on cyberbullying?
As far as handling criticism is concerned, I think we were talking about inspiration and role models earlier. I think I learned a lot from my parents, especially from my father. I don't know. I think you need to be focused on your priorities. You need to know. I think after a while, you kind of know how to block certain energies that don't match with yours, and you need to know how to focus on the things that are important for you in your life, and be true to the things that you do. You know,
know, I think criticism will always, I think sometimes is a good thing, in fact. But I think thanks to being a sportsman and being an athlete, I think you learn how to make that constructive. I had a lot of criticism when I first came into the industry for my abilities and so on and so forth. But I think you kind of learn, instead of allowing it to have a negative effect on you, I think there's always a way to allow that to be positive. And how do you work on those things? But you also need to know how to filter and say, okay, this is good criticism and this is rubbish. This is irrelevant. So how do you do that? I think that's important. And sorry, what's the second?
So what's your take on the cyber bullying?
I'm not even aware if I have been, if I am being or have been bullied. I don't have to worry about that because I have all my fans here who literally like fight for me. And that's what I'm saying. It's, you know, it's knowing that you have these amazing people who are your strength. I don't even have to do anything. But at the same time, it's, I think, related to the earlier question, which is knowing how to block and staying focused and concentrating on doing what you have to do. And yeah.
Hi, Deepika. We all know you love acting, you love your fans, you love Bollywood, you now also love Hollywood, maybe. So, but if you had one day without all this, without acting, without stardom, without all of this, because we human beings are always looking for something more, what would that be? What would you do in that day, or what would you want apart from?
I would just want to spend time with my family, nothing else. I think it's important for us to, you know, or maybe that's the stage of, you know, where I am in my life. I think I've been away for too long now, and I feel, feel every day the value that that my parents bring, or my, you know, my sister, and that feeling of feeling complete and being completely at peace when you're with your family. You go back to being the daughter, that's something I really miss. So at any given point, that's what I always like to do.
Is that for me?
Yes. For your fans, which was in love.
So thank you, everyone. Thank you for doing this, and thank you for being here. And I love you lots. And I promise to stay connected and have a lot more fun, do a lot more lovely movies, hopefully. Yeah, thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you very, very soon. Thank you.